Hello to all. Welcome to Momentum IS. This is Jyoti. Today we are going to proceed with the second part of Unsung Heroines of the Freedom Struggle. In our earlier session, we have discussed about five prominent Indian freedom fighters, which were Suhasini Ganguly, Pushpalata Das, Beena Das, Parbati Giri, and Mattagini Hazra. In today's session, we are going to discuss four more prominent women freedom fighters and their glorious achievements in attainment of India's independence. So let's start this session. First, we discuss about Janaki Thevar. Janaki Thevar was the founding member of Malaysian Indian Congress. The Malaysian Indian Congress was a political party. In fact, it is a political party because it is still in existence. And this party formed in 1946 by John Thievey. So John Thievey met Gandhiji at London while studying law. So he was very much influenced by Gandhian idea and was determined to fight for the cause of India's independence. Janaki Thevar was influenced by Subhash Chandra Bose's call for independence as well. So that's why she joined INA at a very young age of 16 years. In fact, her determination was so much that she even donated her earrings for the cause of India's independence. And she was brought up in a well-to-do family, so that her early days in INA camps were indicative of her struggle, because in the camp they had to survive from hand to mouth living. So here she struggled, but eventually she emerged as a true heroine. Other achievement of Janaki Thevar was she was part of Rani Jhansi Regiment, which was the part of INA led by Subhash Chandra Bose ji. And her entry into INA was strongly objected by her father. Why? Because there was a rule in INA that if koi unmarried ladki hoti hai, so they have to get the consent of their father, and in case of married girl, so they need require the consent of her husband. So in this case, Janaki Thevar ke father ne unko consent basically itna nahi diya tha, so he strongly objected her entry into the INA. Further achievement of Janaki Thevar is she was second in command in this regiment. When INA was put into actions, she was second in command. And in her own words, she talked about the marathon walk of Rangoon to Bangkok, where she expressed that she covered more than 23 days through virgin forest, and she faced most difficult terrain in blinding darkness with turbulent rivers and streams, marching in drenched and tattered uniforms. So these were the hardships that INA soldiers were faced, and they showcased exemplary behavior of a true nationals. Eventually, she, after INA struggle, when the Second World War ended, and the Second World War ended in 1945. So in the Second World War, she emerged as a welfare activist, where she diverted her attention to emancipate the sufferings of the injured in the Second World War. Moving further, another freedom fighter which is of prominence in nature is Basanti Devi. Basanti Devi wife thi Chitranjan Das ki, jinko hum deshbandhu bhi bolte hain pyar se. She was married to Chitranjan Das, and Chitranjan Das was associated with Swaraj Party as well as INC. So this Swaraj Party was formed in 1923 by the pro-changers. She was arrested during NCM in 1921. So this NCM showcased her active participation in the national movement. She was saddened with the sudden death of Lala Lajpat Rai. Lala Lajpat Rai was, as we know, was brutally injured in the lathi charge, and he succumbed to his injuries and died in 1928. So, when he died, so उन्होंने एक protest organize करा, where she gathered number of youths, and this protest was against the brutal atrocities that Britishers committed against the Indians or against the nationals like Lala Lajpat Rai. And she is also considered as the adoptive mother of Subhash Chandra Bose. क्योंकि Subhash Chandra Bose E.R. Das को अपना political guru मानते थे, तो he considered her as adoptive mother. Now, Basanti Devi was also associated with Tilak Swaraj Fund. This Tilak Swaraj Fund was formulated in 1921 during NCM movement by Gandhiji as a homage to Bal Gangadhar Tilak on his first death anniversary. So the target of Tilak Fund was they had to collect 1 crore. And even they were succeeded in collecting over 1 crore rupees. Other achievements of Basanti Devi were, she even took the charge of publishing weekly journal of her husband, C.R. Das, and उस journal का नाम था बांग्लार कथा. ये बांग्लार कथा को वो publish करती थी after her husband was arrested. And इस बांग्लार कथा में she even published a poem of काजी नजरुल इस्लाम. ये काजी नजरुल इस्लाम was a or is considered as the national poet of Bangladesh. Further achievement of Basanti Devi is, वो president भी थी Bengal Provincial Congress की in 1921-22. Moving further, other prominent woman freedom fighter we'll discuss is Sushila Devi. अब Sushila Devi जी की early life के बारे में ये देखते हैं. She got her education from Arya Women College, which is situated in Jalandhar. अभी Arya Women College was considered as the center of women revolutionaries because काफ़ी prominent women women were associated with this college, which were Shanno Devi and Kumari Lajpati Devi. Sushila Devi ji ki inspiration ab hum dekhte hain how she got familiarized with the revolutionary ideas is that she was highly inspired by the Kakori conspiracy case. This Kakori conspiracy case took place in 1925 when nationalists like Ashfaq Ullah Khan, Ram Prasad Bismil, so they looted the train in the Kakori and eventually they were arrested and they were hanged, or we can say they martyred. So this is the about Kakori conspiracy which inspired Sushila Devi. Other development which inspired her and is the Hindustan Socialist Republican Association, or we can popularly known as HSRA. So it was formed in 1928, and this HSRA was the successor of HRA, that is Hindustan Republican Association, which was formed in 1924. The difference between the two is here this HRA got infused with the, or we can say got inspired with the socialist idea. So this is the formation of HSRA, and prominent leaders like Bhagat Singh and Bhagwati Charan Vora, so they were associated with HSRA. Sushila Devi even helped Bhagat Singh when he escaped after assassinating Saunders. In fact, he mistakenly killed Saunders, and his intention was to kill the superintendent of police, James Scott, which was the in charge of the lathi charge where Lala Lajpat Rai was brutally injured. and this the Lahore this came to be known as the Lahore conspiracy case, where Sushila Devi helped Bhagat Singh in providing shelter. Even she was associated with Bhagat Singh Defence Committee as well, which where she collected the funds for the under trials in this Lahore conspiracy case. Moving further with the achievement of Sushila Devi, we came to know she was the lady of multi-talent. As she wrote a play known as Mewar Patan. Aur is play mein she mainly focused on delivering the revolutionary ideas, inspiring the youth about the revolutionary ideologies. She even took the command of the Delhi and Lahore after these three prominent leaders were hanged, Bhagat Singh, Sukhdev and Rajguru. They all were hanged on 23rd March 1931. So after these leaders got martyred, she took the command of the Delhi, Lahore. So such was the posturing of this strong lady. She even formulated the plan, which is known as the Lahore Kirk plan. So इस पूरी वीडियो में सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट ऑफ द फ्रीडम फाइटर हम कवर कर रहे हैं, एंड द मोस्ट प्रोमिनेंट आस्पेक्ट हेयर इज द लाहौर किर्क प्लान. इसमें क्या हुआ, शी अलॉन्ग विद द अदर रेवोल्यूशनरीज हैश्ड अ प्लान टू किल द सेक्रेटरी ऑफ द पंजाब गवर्नमेंट, एंड दैट सेक्रेटरी का नाम था सर हेनरी किर्क. बट इवेंचुअली ये फेल्ड प्लान था बिकॉज वन ऑफ द की मेम्बर विच वॉज नोन एज जगदीश, so he was killed by the police, so the plan was not put into the action. So this is very important, Lahore Kirk plan from the PT perspective. Other development we can look of into the life of her is Pandit Paramanand of Jhansi ne unko proclaim kara tha John of Arc of India. Abhi John of Arc of India, अब दिस फ्रेज ऑफ जॉन ऑफ आर्क रेफर्स टू दी एक फ्रांस की हीरोइन थी विच वॉज प्रोमिनेंट इन दी 100 ईयर्स वॉर. सो दिस बिकॉज ऑफ द ब्रेवरी शी शोकेस्ड, शी वॉज गिवन द टाइटल जॉन आर्क ऑफ इंडिया, एंड ऑल्सो बिकॉज ऑफ इग्नाइटिंग द स्पिरिट ऑफ रेवोल्यूशन अमंग द मासेस. मूविंग फर्दर, लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट, Labonia Prabha Ghosh, the last woman freedom fighter of this session. She was popularly known as Manbhumi Janani. And unke father ek headmaster the kahan ke Purulia Zilla school ke. Despite her father being a headmaster, she didn't attain any formal education. Ab ye dekh sakte hain, the reason would be ki this showcases the conservative outlook that the society held against the women in that era. And Labonia Prabha Ghosh was also associated with Shilp Ashram, which was founded by her father and her husband Atul Chandra Ghosh in Tikal Para, which is in Purulia. And this center Purulia is very important and is considered as the center for the revolutionaries' activities or the meetings, or even Congress leaders were highly associated with this center. The prominent leaders like Mahatma Gandhi ji, Subhash Chandra Bose, Chittaranjan Das, so they regularly hold their meeting in Purulia. She also participated in Salt Satyagraha and also organized this flag satyagraha, jisko hum pataka satyagraha bhi bolte hain. Kahan pe organize kara tha? Konapara in 1945. Further development of her is she was the first woman chosen as a member of Lok Seva Sangh in Purulia. This Labonia also organized Bhasha Andolan. कहाँ पर ऑर्गेनाइज करा था? मनभूम डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑर्गेनाइज कराता है एंड दिस भाषा आंदोलन वॉज डायरेक्टेड अगेंस्ट द स्टेट विच ट्राइड टू इम्पोज द हिंदी लैंग्वेज ओवर द बंगाली स्पीकिंग पॉपुलेशन. सो शी स्ट्रांगली ऑब्जेक्टेड दिस एक्शन ऑफ द स्टेट. हर फर्दर अचीवमेंट वी कैन सी इज शी वॉज ऑल्सो अरेस्टेड फॉर दिस एक्ट ऑफ हर इट एंड इवन शी वॉज हाईली इन्वॉल्व इन द मूवमेंट वेयर the district of Purulia was brought under the West Bengal. So in this case we can say she was a true nationalist which devoted her life, her energies for the cause of the country. Now this is the end of our session of discussion about the women freedom fighters. So let's discuss one PT question and one mains question. Before that I would like to discuss something. कि वी द टीम ऑफ मोमेंटम आयर्स वी आर ओवरवेलम्ड विद द रिस्पॉन्सेज वी रिसीव्ड विद रिगार्ड टू अनसंग हीरोइंस ऑफ द वुमेन फ्रीडम फाइटर्स. सो वी रिसीव नंबर ऑफ क्वेरीज एंड उनमें से सबसे फ्रीक्वेंट क्वेश्चन दे आस्ट इज कि वेदर दिस टॉपिक इज सिग्निफिकेंट फ्रॉम द पीटी परस्पेक्टिव और द मेन्स परस्पेक्टिव. सो आई वॉन्ट टू क्लियर द थिंग्स आउट हेयर कि ये टॉपिक इज वेरी मच apt or we can say very much significant from the PT as well as mains perspective and how you can look into ki exam mein kaise questions they can ask is here we are going to discuss one PT question and one mains question so the things will be get much clearer and easier. So one PT question is consider the following statements. तो पहला स्टेटमेंट ये है कि लाहौर किर्क प्लान वॉज फॉर्मुलेटेड टू किल द सेक्रेटरी ऑफ द पंजाब गवर्नमेंट सर हेनरी किर्क एंड सुशीला दीदी वॉज पार्ट ऑफ दिस सक्सेसफुल एंडेवर. अब हमें पता है, हमने पढ़ा है कि लाहौर किर्क प्लान वॉज हैश्ड बाय सुशीला देवी एंड अदर रेवोल्यूशनरीज टू किल द सेक्रेटरी ऑफ द पंजाब गवर्नमेंट सर हेनरी किर्क. सो यहाँ तक तो इट इज़ ओके, बट सुशीला दीदी वॉज पार्ट ऑफ इट इज अगेन हेयर वी कैन से इट्स ऑल गोइंग ऑल फाइन. बट वट is the we can say key element to be focused in this statement is the this successful ki ye plan successful tha ya nahi. So there can be two we can say chances ki aapko ye Lahore Kirk plan ke bare mein pata hai to you can is there is one chance. The other chances aapko is plan ke bare mein nahi pata. The second chance is agar nahi pata hai most probably you will not attempt this question. अगर पता है उसमें भी एट टाइम्स यू मेक इट दिस स्टेटमेंट एज इनकरेक्ट. कैसे इज ये एक लाहौर किर्क प्लान था जिसे को पता है सुशीला देवी पार्ट ऑफ इट. जैसे हमने पढ़ा है कि लाहौर किर्क प्लान वाज नॉट सक्सेसफुल. व्हाई? जैसे वन ऑफ द की मेंबर व्हिच इज़ नोन एज जगदीश ही वाज किल्ड बाय द पुलिस. सो दिस प्लान वाज नॉट पुट इनटू एक्शन. तो दिस प्लान वाज नॉट सक्सेसफुल. तो यहाँ पर यूपीएससी विल प्ले ट्रिक्स. ठीक है, so this statement is not correct and the second statement is direct and simple which we have discussed under Labonia Prabha Ghosh. ye hai ki bhasha andolan in she organized in Manbhum district against the obligatory imposition of Hindi over the Bengalis after the independence. So this statement is correct and which so this comes out to be only statement 2 is correct, that is option B is correct. Now let's discuss one mains question. अब इसमें क्या है, the question is very much direct. कि mention the prominent roles played by women freedom fighters during the colonial era. Question is very much direct. But direct question and simple question को answer करना, that to maintain the quality is itself is a tough task. अब इसमें क्या करेंगे, first we'll introduce simply कि women freedom fighters were active and played an instrumental role in attainment of independence for the country. This is the introduction. And body में क्या करेंगे, we'll write, अभी तक हमने total 9 women freedom fighters के बारे में हमने पढ़ा है. So we can write the roles but keep key aspect in mind कि हमें कुछ significant points लिखने हैं. जैसे हमने last session में पढ़ा था about छत्री संघा. Do mention about छत्री संघा, इसको आप लीव नहीं करना है. एंड डू मैंशन अबाउट दिस लाहौर किर्क प्लान. सो ये क्या है, ये कुछ एलिमेंट्स विल प्रोवाइड यू एज ओवर दी अदर्स वेयर यू कैन फेच मोर मार्क्स. एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट element in this question that you do not need to miss to provide value to your answer is challenges. Challenges ko mat bhooliye, do mention about the challenges. In the previous session, we have discussed about, we have conducted a small analysis about this woman freedom fighters. We have, where we have mentioned about the challenges. So challenges mein, I told you ki women, they played a secondary role, that is only providing shelter to the revolutionaries, or they safeguarded the bombs or the weapons. Other is their own cause subordinated by the cause for the country. So these are the challenges we have discussed. So do mention about these challenges. And agar 10 marker hai, conclude with the challenge. And even and in case of 15 marker, you can aap ek separately body ke under challenge as a paragraph likh sakte hain and conclude with simple aspect with this phrase ki unsung heroines. So conclude, and these were the unsung heroines, but their actions were truly echoed far and wide. So this is the end of our session. Thank you.